From the OU TV Broadcast Center in Los Angeles, California, this is Brief News Brief, a brief look at today's trending news topics. Proudly combating the thought police since 2016, here's your host, James Heaney.
I'm James Heaney, and this is Brief News Brief. Pop quiz. You get an email from the Russian government saying that they want to help you win an American democratic election, and they're going to send some emissaries with some information about your opponents. Do you take the meeting? Well, we know what Donald Trump would do, because like he does with all his thoughts, he put them up on Twitter this morning. He says, most politicians would have gone to the meeting like the one Don Jr. attended in order to get info on an opponent. That's politics. At the same time, everyone else in the world, well, not everyone, but let's say the majority, believes that you should not have taken that meeting. In fact, they think that there should have been a big red flashing light saying, call the FBI, call the FBI, call the FBI. Basically, someone should have known better. If it wasn't Daniel Jr., but then maybe Paul Manafort should have known not to take a meeting with the Russians, for God's sakes. Meanwhile, in South Korea, they announced today that they are willing to hold military talks with North Korea to relieve tensions. It's believed here in the United States that North Korea's long-range missile program could be weaponized within a year or so with a miniaturized nuclear warhead that could reach the United States. The Senate had hoped to get the new health care bill up for a vote this week, but those hopes are now dashed against the rocks of the ocean, right? They're on hold. Senator John McCain is now recovering from surgery to remove a blood clot from his head, specifically the eyeball area, and he's not going to be in Washington this week. Without McCain, the Republicans do not have enough votes to advance the measure. So Mitch McConnell is waiting for McCain to return for a key procedural vote. Elon Musk, billionaire CEO of Tesla and SpaceX, is certain that robots will be able to do everything better than humans pretty soon. He says he's not sure what to do about it, and that's the scariest problem in the world to him. Now, transportation operators are going to be the first to lose their jobs, says Musk. The U.S. Department of Transportation says 1 in 7 jobs in the U.S. is transportation-related at the very most part. But no job is safe. Robots are getting faster, robots are getting smarter, and this is all occurring faster than we expected. Roger Federer makes history, winning the 8th Wimbledon title at the age of 35. He didn't lose in a set the entire tournament. And finally in the news, I've been doing lots of live streams on Twitch. So if you don't know that, it's The Real James Heaney on twitch.tv. I'll be doing it today at 4 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, which I believe would be 7 p.m. Eastern Time. So come and check that out. Sailors sequestered at sea, sometimes sea serpents, but an elephant? It's laughable. A Sri Lankan patrol boat spotted one struggling in a current 10 miles from shore. Notified, the Navy niftily navigated numerous knots to the buoying beast, wrapped the compliant creature in ropes, and pulled the paddling psychoderm to the playa. Authorities do not believe the elephant intentionally went swimming in as much as he did not have his trunks. And now it's your time to chime. What, does a cat have your tongue? There were no comments in the last video. How am I supposed to have your time to chime if you're not chiming? I mean, come on, put some chime in.